What do we know about the YouTube suggested videos algorithm in 2020? Let's look at what it is, how it works under the hood, and how to trigger it so that this algorithm brings you more views to your videos. Alright, let's get started with what is the suggested videos algorithm. You obviously watched YouTube beforehand, and if you are at the video, these videos at the site, these are driven by the suggested videos algorithm. And of course, we want our videos to appear in this list. Ideally, actually, in the very first position here at the top, which is labeled with up next, because this video here will come in autoplay. So in particular, if viewers are watching your videos on a TV, they oftentimes let the videos autoplay one after the other. And this is a perfect position to be in because this one will come next after this video when those people just let it play. But how do your videos appear in this list? Ideally, quite high up in this list. So for that, we have to understand how the algorithm works under the hood, how those suggestions are made by YouTube. These suggestions that we see here are in part made based on this video that the viewer is currently watching. As you can see here, this video is about SEO on YouTube. So naturally, it's recommending other SEO videos like this one, this one, this one, something. For example, understanding the algorithm which is related to SEO here, all those videos that are topically related. So this is one half of the videos that you see in the suggested videos section. The other half of the videos are not related to the video that the viewer is currently watching. Those are rather based on what the viewer is usually interested in watching, and that could be a video that is not at all in the realm of what the video you see here right now. So for example, natural language processing in Python. That is a programming topic and doesn't have anything to do with YouTube. So this is an example, After Effects character animations, for example, as well. These videos are decided to be shown on a different basis. This different basis is similar to the home algorithm, by the way. Yeah, and the home algorithm, I will be doing a similar video like this one, which you will see in the end screen of this video. So let's move that aside. You can later watch the video about the home algorithm, where you will understand how the second half of videos appear in the suggested videos section. Let's focus on the first half first. Those videos that are suggested because they are topically related to the video that the viewer is currently watching. So how does the suggested videos algorithm know that it should show these videos next to this video? And that is, by the way, a very important understanding that we later need in order to trigger this algorithm to let our videos appear in the suggested videos section. So how does the algorithm know which videos to show? I bet all of you already shopped on Amazon, right? And you know, when you are looking up a product like this book, for example, you have the section here, customers who bought this item also bought, and these other book recommendations. And that is actually the same thing that we have on YouTube. We have our video here and the suggested videos next to it. So the idea is the same. Viewers who watch this video also watch these videos. So the algorithm learns from all the viewers that your video has. What do they watch next? And do they also enjoy it? And based on that, they can do these recommendations to new viewers of your video. Let me give you a very precise explanation for that. When your video goes live, then you have many different viewers watching your video. But some viewers are watching it before the other viewers, right? The first viewers who watch your video are first your subscribers, obviously, and second, those people who come through search, for example. So we have these groups here. Subscribers watch your video first, people from search watch your video first, and then the algorithm starts to find similar people. People with similar interests. They are kind of like doppelgangers of your people who come from search or your subscribers, they have similar interests. Remember, customers who bought this item also bought this items. Yeah, these previous customers are your doppelgangers as a viewer. The same thing is here. Let's look at two groups of viewers to make it a little bit more simple. So you have your subscribers who already watch your new video, let's say of a series that has two episodes. They watched this video first, enjoyed it, and then watched the second episode next. Now, the suggested videos algorithm looks for other people who have similar interests like these, and those people happen to watch episode 1 as well. And since your subscribers watched episode 2 next, it now knows, since these people enjoyed episode 1, they should be recommended episode 2 as well, because these people enjoyed that next, so the chance is high that this group of people also enjoys the second episode of your series. That is the thinking that the suggested videos algorithm does there, and it shows it to more and more people if the similar people also enjoy your videos. The process is like this. As I said in the beginning, subscribers and those people from search watch your video next. So then it looks for the next groups of people. But only if those initial groups really enjoyed the video. And that is high click-through rate and high watch time. Yeah, given that your subscribers or the people from search really enjoyed your new video, then the suggested videos algorithm is motivated to give this video, recommend this video to more similar people in a way that I just explained it. So because they enjoyed it, it shows it to the next similar people here. So for example, those watched it, and next this group of people also watch it. And let's say they also enjoyed it with a high click-through rate and a high watch time. Well, then the algorithm is motivated to show it to even more similar people here. But it doesn't cascade it like this to show it to more and more people all the time. Not all people enjoy watching your videos. That's just natural. So, for example, it shows it to more people and they have a low click-through rate. And the few people who watch it have high watch time, but since the low click-through rate is there, well, it doesn't show it to even more people anymore. So it stops here. Or let's say high click-through rate, but low watch time. Or low click-through rate and low watch time. So if people don't enjoy it, yeah, those next groups of people, well, then it stops promoting it to more people. But as you see here, if they enjoy it again, it does promote it to more people. Yeah, so there is no workaround in creating a great video that people really enjoy. And the better you do it, the more this suggested video algorithm cascades it to more and more people, and your video will get more and more outreach. But the question is, now that we understand how the algorithm works under the hood, how can you trigger it to get more views? And I gave you a few hints already. First of all, they have to enjoy watching it. Only if that is the case, then the algorithm promotes your video further to more people. But also, it has to gain the information about, like on Amazon, people who buy this book also bought these books. Yeah, same on YouTube. People who watch this video also watched these videos next. And that is the critical point to trigger the suggested videos algorithm. You have to make your viewers, especially those initial viewers, your subscribers, those people coming from search, watch your video, not only your video, your new video, but also other videos next. Ideally, you would create series, so that people can watch your videos in a row, because that is what the suggested videos algorithm really looks at. The question basically is, which videos do people watch in a row? And this order of watching videos is reflected in the suggestions that you have next to the video. Yeah, video 1, and these were video 2 for those people who already watched my video in the past. All right. Series. You probably think about playlists at this point, right? You can use playlists, but it's really not the whole story. What you need to make happen is that people are actually watching your videos in a row. And simply a playlist doesn't do the job most of the times. Although it of course helps, what you need to do is at the end of your video, for example, when the end screen appears, then you have to pitch one of your videos that the viewers should watch next. Motivate them to watch the video next. By the way, this is a really great and effective strategy that you can use for the end screen as well as for cards. And to tell you all about how to make this strategy happen, check out this video. It's really simple in the end, but you have to do it in order to create these binge watch sessions that videos are watched in a row, because this in turn is the data for the suggested algorithm to know which videos to recommend next to your videos. Of course, your goal is that your video appears in the suggested videos section next to a big channel's video, right? The strategy here is start with your own videos on your own channels, which you can influence with adding cards, adding end screen elements, recommending people to watch other of your videos, so that you have these binge watch sessions on your own channel. If you make this happen, then almost automatically the suggested videos algorithm will pick that up, those binge watch sessions, and use the information to even recommend your videos next to videos on other channels. And that is how you trigger the suggested videos algorithm. But I have to say, in this regard, the suggested videos algorithm is just one of the three major algorithms that drive views to channels. And it is usually the third algorithm that kicks in. The first algorithm that small channels can use is the YouTube search algorithm. And the second algorithm is the home algorithm that I mentioned in the beginning. And altogether, these three algorithms, search, home, suggested videos, they together usually make up 75% of all the views that the channel gets. So focusing on these three algorithms to get more views from YouTube's promotion engine, their algorithms, is the way to go. So since we covered the suggested videos algorithm now, well, check out this video for the search algorithm and this video for the home algorithm so that you get a full picture of how to trigger the most important algorithms on YouTube. Cheers, my friends.